हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम निरंजन झा, ए टीचर ऑफ महात्मा गांधी शिक्षण संस्थान दरभंगा। दिस टाइम आई एम गोइंग टू टीच द स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ क्लास 8। दिस इज सब्जेक्ट साइंस, चैप्टर 5। द नेम ऑफ दिस चैप्टर इज कोल एंड पेट्रोलियम। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, दिस टाइम वी हैव टू डिस्कस अबाउट व्हाट आर द लिमिटेशंस ऑफ फॉसिल फ्यूल्स। लिमिटेशंस मीन्स ड्रॉबैक्स। What are the drawbacks of fossil fuels? Although we have read this, but this time we have to revise. There are two limitations of fossil fuel. First is the limited availability. Limited availability means fossil fuels are available in nature in limited quantity. It is not present in unlimited quantity. And we have studied there are two types of resources, exhaustible and inexhaustible. All the fossil fuels are exhaustible natural resources. Fossil fuels are formed from the conversion of dead organism. It takes millions of years. It cannot be replenished within short period of time. So what can be done? How we can overcome this problem? There is only one way to overcome this problem. We have to conserve fossil fuel. All the natural resources, or especially fossil fuels, must be consumed on a limited way, limited speed. If we shall consume these fossil fuels at this present rate, then it may exhaust after 100 years of time. So we must conserve fossil fuels. So this is the first limitation of fossil fuel. Second limitation is air pollution. Air pollution. When fossil fuel burn, especially we are talking here about the coal. When coal burn, then it causes air pollution. This question also may be asked in different way. What are the harmful effects of burning fossil fuel? Or what are the harmful effects of burning coal? This question matter is same, air pollution, but it can be asked in different way. Harmful effects of fossil fuel, burning fossil fuel, or what are the harmful effects of burning coal? What are the different harmful effects? First is the global warming. This is very important and more important harmful effect of burning coal, global warming. And second is the acid rain. We shall discuss both global warming and acid rain one by one in detail. Global warming. When coal burn, it produces carbon dioxide gas, and this carbon dioxide gas causes global warming. We shall discuss how it causes global warming. And second is the acid rain. When coal burn, it produces sulfur. This sulfur combined with oxygen and forms sulfur dioxide. This sulfur dioxide again react with water present in the atmosphere, and it forms sulfurous acid. This sulfurous acid dissolves in rainwater and comes down, and then it causes acid rain. When nature of rainwater is acidic, then it is called acid rain. One thing must be clear. During acid rain, it is not that only acid will comes down. Acid rain is not a rain of acid. But actually what happens? The nature of rainwater becomes acidic. That is acid rain. And what are the harmful effects of acid rain? Acid rain is harmful for all the living and non-living things. We shall write here one by one. First we shall discuss how global warming takes place. Then discuss how acid rain takes place. Global warming. This is our Earth surface. This is our Earth surface. We are here. And Earth surface is surrounded by an atmosphere. This is sun. Sun's rays reaches to the Earth surface. Then what happens? Earth surface becomes heated, and again it radiates energy. Heat comes out from Earth surface. Some heat goes out of the atmosphere. Some amount of heat goes out of atmosphere. This is heat energy. This is heat energy, and some heat is entrapped by the layer of CO2. In the atmosphere, there are carbon dioxide, water vapor, dust, etc. There are different things in the atmosphere. Some heat are entrapped by these things, and this heat remains in the surface of the earth. Then what happens? Due to this entrapped heat by carbon dioxide, water vapor, earth surface becomes warm. The temperature of earth surface are being maintained. Carbon dioxide is necessary. The presence of carbon dioxide is necessary. If there will be no carbon dioxide, then what will happen? All the heat will go out, and again earth surface will be very cool, and then our life will be not possible. So it is necessary. But what happens? How global warming takes place? When amount of percentage of carbon dioxide increases, then more and more heat is entrapped in the earth surface. When amount of carbon dioxide is increased, then more and more heat is entrapped in the earth surface, and then temperature of earth surface increases. This is the global warming. And how we can define? The increase in average temperature of earth surface is known as global warming. The increase in average temperature of earth surface is known as global warming. Clear? I think it is clear. Sun's rays reaches to the earth surface. Earth surface becomes heated. When earth surface becomes heated, then again it radiates heat. And some heat goes out of atmosphere, and some heat is entrapped by the water vapor, carbon dioxide, and many other gases, due to which temperature of earth surface increases. There are many factors which increases the temperature of earth surface, but the main gas is carbon dioxide. So carbon dioxide is known as global warming gas. It is also known as greenhouse effect. Which gas is known as global warming gas, or which gas is known as greenhouse effect, greenhouse gas? That is carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide is the main factor due to which earth surface, temperature of earth surface increases. And why carbon dioxide increases in the atmosphere? One most important reason is burning of coal. When coal burns, it releases carbon dioxide, which goes to atmosphere, and the temperature of earth surface increases and causes global warming. Now, what are the harmful effects of global warming? When temperature of earth surface becomes high, then what happens? This is the mountain on the earth surface, and we know mountain, the tips of the mountains are full of ice. When temperature rises, then this ice will melt. Ice melts and comes down in the form of water, goes to the river. And then what happens? It causes flood. When global warming takes place, then more and more ice caps melt, comes down, goes to the river, and it causes flood. This is global warming. Now we have to discuss acid rain. Now we have to discuss what is acid rain. When coal burns, then it releases sulfur gas. This sulfur gas goes to the atmosphere. Suppose this is a stack. Coal burns and this releases smoke. Smoke contains sulfur, S. This, and in the atmosphere oxygen is also present there. When coal burns, it releases sulfur. Sulfur goes to atmosphere. In the atmosphere, it combines with oxygen present in the atmosphere. S plus O2. O2 means oxygen. And then it forms SO2. What is SO2? Sulfur dioxide. Sulfur plus oxygen, this is sulfur dioxide. Now what happens? In the atmosphere, water vapor is also present there. This sulfur dioxide combined with water vapor, water in the form of vapor, this form H2SO3, this is sulfurous acid, this H2SO3 is sulfurous acid. This sulfurous acid combined with rain water and comes down, this is rain, this is rain. When acid mix with rain water, then what happens? The nature of rain water becomes acidic. Rain water becomes acidic rain water. Acidic rain water. This rain water becomes acidic, and this is known as acid rain. And we have already discussed in the acid rain does not mean that acid will comes down. What happens in acid rain? Only the nature of rain water becomes acidic. Just revise it. When coal burn, this is burning coal. There are coal burns. When coal burns, it releases sulfur, sulfur gas. This sulfur goes to atmosphere and combine with oxygen of atmosphere and it forms sulfur dioxide. This sulfur dioxide combined with water, this water is also present in the atmosphere in the form of water vapor. This sulfur dioxide combined with water vapor, water, and then it forms acid, H2SO3. This is known as sulfurous acid. This sulfurous acid mix with water, rain water, and comes down in the form of acid rain. This acid rain is harmful for all the living and non-living things. When this acidic rain water falls on the body of living things, then it creates itching. It causes a skin problem. Crops destroy. All the trees, all the plants destroy. And when this acidic rain water falls on non-living things, just for example, on any tower, mobile tower, electric tower, road, building, everything gets corroded. So it is harmful for all living and non-living things. Acid rain takes place due to many other gases, but the main gas responsible for acid rain is sulfur dioxide. Which gas is responsible for acid rain? Sulfur dioxide. And which gas is responsible for global warming? Carbon dioxide. Which gas is responsible for acid rain? Sulfur dioxide. These are the small things you must memorize. Third effect, air pollution. Third effect is release of carbon monoxide. Release of carbon monoxide. When carbon burn completely, then it releases carbon dioxide. And when carbon do not burn completely, when coal do not burn completely, then it releases carbon monoxide, CO, carbon monoxide. Monoxide, CO. What are the harmful effects? This CO is a smellless and poisonous gas. When it is inhaled by any person, then it replaces oxygen from the hemoglobin and then it causes suffocation or it also may cause death. Then it causes a smoke. When coal burn, it releases a smoke. A smoke contains a large number of unburned carbon particles. What happens? When this smoke goes to the atmosphere, then it may be inhaled by the person. When it is inhaled by the person, then it causes breathing problem. Always, it causes respiratory problem or breathing problem. And due to unburned carbon particle, that wherever a smoke goes, the sub place becomes black. These are the harmful effects of the burning coal, burning fossil fuel. Now, fossil fuel has two limitations. One is the limited availability. This can be overcome by conservation. And second is the air pollution. In the air pollution, there are many factors. One is the release of carbon dioxide, which causes global warming. Second, release of sulfur, mainly sulfur, which causes acid rain. Then it releases carbon monoxide, which causes suffocation and may cause death. And then fourth is it releases smoke, which causes respiratory problem. This limitations of fossil fuel can be asked in different way. Revise it and you write everything in detail. Thanks.